Suave Boomer with another ASMR video. I'm exhausted from school, and usually when I'm this drained, I pick something up before I get home, but I was so tired, all I was thinking about was let me lay down in bed. So I got home, lay down in bed for about 20 minutes, got hungry, realized that I don't want to cook anything big at all, but at the same time, I don't want to go pick something up, so I've made these before. I think it was like ASMR number 4. It's like way back when I first started the channel. Those were from the ones I made in my first video were definitely from scratch. They were wheat, cornbread, turkey, chili, everything I just made from scratch. It was like I just took time to do it. This is the bootleg version. The cornbread is just crusties out the box. Took 20 minutes to make in the oven, and I made them in the toaster oven. The chili is from a can, and it's veggie chili. I don't know how I feel about that. I wanted to try it out. I got some light sour cream, some light cheddar cheese, some chives, and I have my Canada Dry Diet Ginger Ale. So, as you can tell, I got out of my fucking shirt. So nice. I'm gonna do a little bit of prepping. This is not a stepping stone for me to start doing cooking, no. Let me show you the corn muffins. Here are the corn muffins. Usually I make like a block of the wheat cornbread, and I cut like a big square, like a big old square, and I put it on the plate. I only had one box. So I think I'm going to use maybe like, these aren't that big, so maybe I'll do like 3. Okay, yeah, let's do 3. So I got 3 corn muffins here, right? And then I got the chili. I'm just going to pour it. Yeah, I pour it right on, so. Looks so fucking fat. Okay, that's good. A little bit more. And then I have, this is my favorite, Sargento's reduced fat sharp cheddar cheese. Light sour cream. Just a little dollop there. And the chives that I cut up. These are really, really good. Put it right on top. Shit, it's been like 4 minutes. Let me show you. Oh, crap. Oh, we're looking good. Yeah, I'm kind of annoyed that I had to like, I know I didn't have to, but I kind of just wanted to try something different, and prepping this was different. and it took about 5 minutes off of the video. Lame. Anyways, let's get into it. Oh, hell yeah. So good. Shit is super easy to make, guys. It's nice to have, like, when it's really cold outside. It's not cold outside today. It's actually really nice. But I was racking my brain to what I was gonna make for lunch and for a video. Chili's not that bad, I guess. Like, you just can't really tell that it's vegetarian because there's so many spices in it. Plus, I added like a bunch of hot sauce to it and made it really hot. School today was fucking yeah, it was a hot mess. It's like when you it's like when you think you're doing good and then something happens and you're like, fuck, all I can do is step it up, I guess. Stressing me out. We have a whole bunch of new people, and it's not working out quite like we wanted to work out. And I unfortunately recommended one of the people. Never again. Nope. Never again. Never doing that again. I was really convinced that this person was good, and from the beginning and remember the beginning. If you think back, remember when Rick used to be like, just, you know, let me find the good in everybody, and, you know, kumbaya, and everything's positive and we'll work it out and blah blah blah, and excuse me, like in most of the last episode, and I was getting a little bit worried because Daryl wasn't, he's like very cautious about that place. Carol, she's playing the part. She's like, let me be housewife and, you know, do this and do that. She's definitely lying and playing the part, which is good. I definitely don't think Carol was genuine at all. Excuse me. Oh, then my God. Through the episode. And then, Carl got himself a little girlfriend. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. And, I love the part where he's like, these people aren't us. They're weak. But I basically, the whole episode was, you could read this person, you could read that person. Daryl was doing this, Carol was doing that, Carl was doing this. You could read everybody. Glenn was doing this. Like, which, by the way, that part where Glenn hit that guy, funny as hell. I don't read the comic, but I've skimmed through it a little bit online. They really make Glenn look like a punk in the comic. Like, he's a nerdy, like, Asian kid. No, he's not that in the show. Anyways, but, yeah, like I said, I could read everybody. Body language and everything. How they felt during that episode. I couldn't read Rick. I mean, I could. But I didn't want to think what I was thinking. I didn't want to think, like, oh, no, he's going back to, like, let me be a cop again. Kumbaya, everybody's happy, we're fine. And it wasn't until the end. And it wasn't until the end when Rick said, and he said it so, like, naturally. He like, just let it flow out. There was no hesitation. He was like, well, I don't know word by word what he said. I don't remember. But he said something along the lines, like, yeah, we'll stay here. And if it works out, it works out. And if it doesn't, we'll take it. I was like, yo, this dude's a G. This dude's a G. He was just straight up like, yo, we'll take it. And fuck that. Yeah, they should. They've been through so much already as a group. I mean, what the fuck else? What can't they handle? What can't they fucking handle? Small, but I'm getting full, man. I can't just throw down in this hole. A lot of bread. But the last, like, 4 or 5 episodes, they've been showing a lot of, I guess, hints about who they're gonna battle next. And, like I said, I don't read the comics, but I look online and I go to websites and I see, like, what they did in the comic book. Well, spoiler alert, but there's this guy, his name is Negan, N-E-G-A-N, Negan, and he, like, his main weapon of choice is, like, a bat wrapped in barbed wire, and, he fucks up Glenn in the comic book. Like, he messes his face all up, like, he loses an eye and everything. He has a tendency to, like, dismember Walker's body parts. And they showed that, in one of the episodes where they found a whole car full of, like, dismembered Walkers with, like, scars on their heads. Negan did that in the comic book. Oh, my God. It's a miracle. It's a miracle. Anyways, guys, I still think they got, like, 2 more episodes of, like, everybody's happy and then trying to settle in. But hit me up in the comments below. Let me know what you think about The Walking Dead, or let me know what you think about what I just ate. Like, don't like, whatever. Subscribe, comment. Thank you for being with me. All right, we'll see you later.